stays back there. Pierre Latour, they've gone now. He's been left now. But if Pierre Latour stays up in that front group, and Nairo Quintana, then they're going to put a little bit of time into Richard Carapaz as well. Carapaz definitely here for the stage victory. Let's keep an eye out now for Elia Viviani. Here we go. That's Pierre Latour off the front, and maybe that's what Bodnar was trying to do, to create a little bit of space, a little bit of time for his team leader. We shouldn't see any problems at all. Well, Elia Viviani, as he takes it towards the end. Luke Grote took him as far as he needed to, and Viviani will take this very easily, as we predicted the whole time. Alaphilippe, I think, finishes third place. It's a victory for Elia Viviani and Ineos Grenadiers. Viviani wasn't even supposed to be here. He's had a second, a third, and a fourth in his last race in Valencia. And now he's come and he's won stage two, or first real stage, of the Tour de la Provence. His first participation at this event, and therefore his first victory as well. Good day for Nairo Quintana, a good day as well for Pierre Latour, pretty good day for Julien Alaphilippe.
Donc il est vainqueur de l'étape du jour. On revoit le sprint.
Sepp van Marck in second.
Est en troisième position.
Julien Alaphilippe
in third. Viviani,
Van Marck,
4 secondes supplémentaires. Donc,
which I'm pretty sure is exactly what we said would happen when we saw this group. Maybe we thought Alaphilippe would come in second.
Deuxième de Paris-Roubaix termine à la même place. Deuxième de l'étape du jour, Julien Alaphilippe. Va prendre des secondes de bonification une nouvelle fois. Il sera prochain. A démontré une nouvelle fois aujourd'hui.
Alors, les sprints
à la fois ici à l'arrivée, les sprints intermédiaires qui lui ont permis eh bien, de prendre des secondes qui seront.
Oh, no problem with the tour, really, for Elia Viviani.
De l'étape finale du
Luke Grove led him out as soon as he needed to. It wasn't really lead out necessary. That's what the guys would have been saying in the cars all along. Nobody was any match for Elia Viviani. Sepp van Marck did his best. Julien Alaphilippe in third. But after the splits, thanks to the wind, just over 100 kilometres to go. From that moment on, it seemed to be relatively straightforward for Ineos Grenadiers to take a victory.
Et puis après Nasser Gouani qui avait remporté la victoire ici-même.